What do you mean by an RF power meter? My name is Rishi Ramju, and welcome to the Backbench Engineering Community, where I make engineering easy for you. So, let us ask ourselves that obvious question. What do you actually mean by the term RF power meters? Well, let's find out. So, RF power meter. Just like the name suggests, this is a device that is used for the purpose of measuring the RF power, that is the power of a signal operating in the radio frequency. So, in the case of an audio power meter, we use to measure the power of audio signals, that is, signals are in the range of an audio signal. But here, in the case of an RF power meter, this is used for the purpose of measuring the radio frequency signals, which is in the range of 3 kHz to 300 GHz. So, the signals that are operating in the range of 3 kHz to 300 GHz are referred to as radio frequency signals. And it is for the purpose of measuring these radio frequency signals, that is, for the purpose of measuring the power of these radio frequency signals, we use an RF power meter. So, in the case of an RF power meter, it actually measures the power that is dissipated at a terminating load. So, for here, in the case of an RF power meter, first we will have an RF signal or a radio frequency signal like this. Now, this power has to be sensed and therefore it is passed through a power sensor. And now, after this power has been sensed, we have to display how much power is present. So, for that, we have a display system over here which displays the power in the terms of watts. Or the power can also be displayed in the terms of decibels. So, this is the basic block diagram of an RF power meter. But how can we actually sense this RF power? How do we sense this? So, for the purpose of sensing this RF power, what we do is that we take a load resistor and we place it across the device that is producing this RF signals. So, if this is an RF source, then across this particular RF source, we actually connect a particular resistor like this. A resistor is connected across this particular RF source. So this resistor has an impedance which is equal to the system impedance. So that is a property of this particular load resistor. So here, if the resistance of this particular load is R0, then this particular resistance is enclosed in a particular environment like this with a temperature sensor over here. So, a temperature sensor is placed over here. So, now the basic idea behind this is that when this RF source is provided to this particular resistor, we know for a fact that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, but it is transformed from one form to another form. So here, over here in the resistance, heat energy starts getting dissipated. So therefore, there will be a heat energy produced over here. And now this temperature sensor will therefore sense this particular heat energy that is dissipated by this particular resistor. And now this heat is converted to either a DC signal or a low frequency AC signal. And now, once the heat is converted to a DC signal or a low frequency AC signal, then we can use simple electronic devices to measure the amount of DC signal or this particular AC signal. And therefore, simply by measuring this particular signal, we can understand how much power is provided by this particular RF signal. As simple as that. This is the basic simple idea behind what you refer to as an RF power meter. As simple as that. So now there are several types of RF power meters. And now one of the common type of RF power meter is a thermistor. So a thermistor RF power meter. So a thermistor is basically a resistor whose value of resistance changes with the change in the temperature. So therefore, with the help of such kind of a resistor, we can make an RF power meter. And such type of an RF power meter is what you refer to as a thermistor RF power meter. Next, we have what we refer to as a bolometer. So they are basically detectors that can detect incident infrared radiations. So therefore, any thermal radiation that is incident on this kind of a bolometer will cause a change in temperature and thereby changing the resistance. As simple as that. So these are some two kinds of RF power meters that are commonly used. A a thermistor RF power meter, and bolometers, as simple as that. So this does sums up what you refer to as an RF power meter. As simple as that, there's nothing more to it. So I hope you guys now have a clear understanding of what you refer to as an RF power meter. And if you guys found this video informative, do hit the like button and join this community by hitting that subscribe button. We'll be discussing about the further topics in the upcoming videos. So stay tuned, stay subscribed. Until next time, I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you.